Today, we continue to explore the method for creating one-shot videos. Our focus today is how to make the entire video look smoother and ensuring that its quality does not decrease as the video duration increases. Let's take a look at the final effect. I use 5 images here. You can consider them 5 keyframes. Let's check it out. It is indeed a one-shot video, and the overall movement and camera scope are relatively large. You'll notice that the biggest issue with this video currently lies in the connection between the segmented videos, which isn't particularly stable. This is because we need to accurately calculate the length of each video and the number of frames for segmentation. Due to time constraints, my current processing isn't ideal. Now, let's look at the basic structure of this workflow. I have also built the workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform through runninghub.ai. In the ComfyUI domain, Running Hub is an excellent online workspace. As soon as new technologies and extensions appear, they follow up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description. This will give you 1,000 free points. Additionally, you get 100 points for logging in every day, allowing you to try out your own workflows. Before explaining this workflow, let's discuss the preparations. Since the workflow we are using is a VACE workflow, we need keyframes. How are these keyframes generated? I am using a method we used previously called next-to-scene. The prompt words for this are generated automatically. You can upload a base image and have it help you generate the next scene. I have currently uploaded an image of a beautiful elf holding a sword. Let's run this workflow and the next scene is generated. Let's look at the initial generated result. This one is a close-up shot, zooming in on the subject. Similarly, you can generate other scenes and the generated quality is relatively high. Next, let's move on to the main workflow we are discussing today. Structurally, this workflow is essentially a VACE start-to-end frame setup. It is necessary to briefly explain the design idea behind the entire workflow. You must note that if we want the quality not to decrease as the video continuously extends, the workflows we can choose are limited. The fundamental characteristic needed is the guarantee of start and end frames. Only by constantly enhancing the video using the start frame and end frame will the video quality not drop. We all know that the last image generated from a text-to-video model is usually of poorer quality. If you use that poor image to continue generating the next segment, the quality will further decay for start to end frames. The first is the standard 1:2:2 start to end frame. Its advantage is that it is relatively easy to implement, and the overall quality is high. Its major disadvantage is that since we use the last frame to directly generate the next video, the connection in action between the two videos tends to be abrupt. Its capability in terms of narrative coherence is slightly weaker. The biggest advantage of VACE is that we can use not only the last frame but also the last few frames as the guiding image. Therefore, the entire video looks smoother and the motion is more fluid. This is why we are using the VACE workflow today to generate these one-shot videos. Structurally, this workflow is divided into two parts. The first part can be considered the base video generation section. We first generate 81 frames of the base video and then extend based on that. The second part is the extension section. Let's look at the first part. Firstly, I use the VACE functionality provided by Alibaba's fund. Since it is based on 1:2:2, this is currently the version closest to the official model. For the main model loading, we use a node from KJNode called Diffusion Model Loader. The biggest advantage of this is that it can connect external modules. We know that VACE is generally injected into the T2V model through an external module. This cannot be achieved using ComfyUI's native nodes, and we must use the KJNode. I use two identical LightX to V acceleration LoRAs here. Following that are our encoder and VAE. The basic configuration has extra settings because we have extension content. In addition to the common width, height, and frame count, we have an option called overlap. This specifies how many frames will overlap between the preceding and succeeding segment to generate the next video. Do not set this too long. I think 7 frames are sufficient. My prompt is also very simple. I directly wrote best quality dynamic motion. Of course, you can use large language models like QWA prompts, which results in better dynamic effects. However, you should note that this workflow is already quite large, so I do not recommend adding any more resource-intensive nodes. Thus, we used a simple general prompt to feed into the workflow. Now, for the most critical part of the entire workflow, first we take the start and end frames and resize them. Then we use the node called OneVideoVase start to end frame. This node is very powerful. We pass our first and last images to it. We then obtain an image and a mask. You'll see that in the image output. Our first picture is placed here, and the second picture is placed here. The middle section is a mid-gray image. That is, its color value is 127. Mid-gray represents the region that is fully redrawable. The corresponding mask also conveys this idea. You will find that the start and end frames are completely uneditable, because their black-white represents areas that can be entirely generated by the model. Thus, these two work together to achieve the start-to-end frame functionality. Similarly, you can organize the image and mask yourself. These two outputs are connected respectively to control video and control mask, which can generate new positive condition, negative condition, and latent. Note that there is something called trim latent here, which indicates how many frames we want to truncate. However, with VACE, this frame count is zero, so whether you truncate or not is irrelevant. Below that is the sampling. I use 8 steps of sampling with the LCM sampler. The first 4 steps are denoising sampling for the high noise model, and the last 4 steps are denoising sampling for the low noise model. I skip this node because, as mentioned, the output is zero, so adding it or not doesn't matter. This process generates our first video, which I call video zero, serving as our base video for the extension. I have 3 keyframes here. The extension of this video relies on these 3 keyframes. We use this node to put them into a single batch. Since they are all the same size, I can resize them as a whole. We must obtain the total number of images, as this determines how many times we need to loop. Then we enter the extension phase. The extension phase is an automatic looping phase, so we use for loop start and for loop end. Our initial value is the first video we generated. Connected to value 1, we must extract some images from this. How many we extract? 7 frames. Because the overlap value I defined here is 7, I can use getImage or mask range from batch. Here, you need to calculate we use the total length minus 7. This gives us the index of the 7th to last frame. Then overlap indicates how many frames we extract. Connect these two outputs to start index and number frames, respectively, to retrieve the desired frames, the last 7 images of the previous video. Once retrieved, they enter our loop. The logic of this loop is essentially the same as before. We also use when video VACE start to end frame. However, note that the start image is now 7 images, not just 1. The end frame is 1 image taken from the keyframe batch. In this step, I am currently taking this specific image. This generates our start to end frame guiding images. Let's look at what the image looks like. This follows the principle we just discussed. Note that we have 7 images. So these 7 are black, and this one is black, meaning there is 1 image here. The middle is all neutral gray, and this corresponding section is all white. It corresponds perfectly. Then, after passing through this node and sampling, we get a video. But note, we cannot take the entire video because 7 frames overlap with the previous video. Now you have 2 options. Either you cut off the last 7 frames of the previous video, or you cut off the first 7 frames of this new video. I personally recommend cutting the first few frames of the new video. After obtaining this segment, we need to combine it with the previous video. We use image batch multi to update video 1 with the newly generated frames. The process then loops again, taking the second keyframe and generating the next section. This loop can continue to generate indefinitely. Let's look at these images overall. You should note that the differences are still quite significant. These two have a strong correlation. One is a close-up, the other is a long shot. But look at the others. There are huge changes in perspective and the overall environment. However, everyone should note that VACE's frame interpolation ability is very strong. Look at the final result generated. First, you will notice that as the video length increases, the quality of the characters and the overall image quality do not decrease because every segment uses start-to-end frames. Moreover, the transitions between scenes are quite smooth, especially the fluidity of the motion, because each segment is generated using the preceding few frames as guiding frames to generate the next video. This is one approach for generating one-shot videos. I hope this provides you with some inspiration and help. That is all for today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.